questions linger about why the interstate was reopened after smog caused a three-car crash hours before that tragedy.
Now, one of the people calling for an investigation is Governor Rick Scott.
WESH News' Dave McDaniel looks at why such an investigation is being called for and what issues will be on the table.
Every time we jump in our cars and we head out onto the interstate, we assume a certain amount of risk. We just have no idea whether the people driving around us are going to be paying close attention. That risk behind the wheel increases at night, especially if there's fog and smoke.
Yeah, unfortunately, you can tell those cars hit at full speed.
Even the guys in the Alachua County Sheriff's helicopter couldn't believe it.
I didn't even realize that was two cars there.
The twisted metal only hints at the tragedy. 10 lives lost.
You just hear everything just hitting and people screaming and stuff.
From a crash victim who feels he cheated death.
Oh, shit! Oh, my God! What is going on?
Okay, we are getting help out there, okay?
Oh, my goodness!
To the people calling 911 who heard what they couldn't see.
Lots of smoke and fog.
Like a lot of fog.
This picture shows the thickness of it. You can't see over the end of the hood. This visibility and the words of the crash victims just 30 minutes after the road was reopened, after a three-vehicle crash closed the road because of the smoke-fog combination.
We came to the conclusion that the road was safe to travel, and that's when we opened the road up.
The governor is asking the Florida Department of Law Enforcement to investigate this incident, seemingly to see if proper procedures were followed when the road reopened.
You can't tell me that that smoke just showed up like that.
In 2008, 70 cars and trucks collided on I-4 in Polk County. Smoke and fog combined that night as well. Look at how bad the visibility was there.
Back in 2008, a trooper driving along I-4 ordered the road closed because of the fog and smoke, but in 7 minutes the collision started. They didn't have time to actually get that road shut down. We've asked about what goes into the decision about opening and closing roads. We're told it's on a case-by-case basis and often with the input from other law enforcement agencies. Now, we have asked specifically about how the decision was made on I-75. Those email questions have not been answered yet. Reporting along I-4, Dave McDaniel, WESH 2 News.